Ryan Spilko here. Today we're gonna review the Legion, wait for it, Dairy IBM M model. It's a one of the first mechanical keyboards. Doesn't work with the Cherry MX switches. It's a whole different technology, and I'm gonna now let my friend speak about his keyboard. Just before I give him free speech, just for a quick comparison of size. As you can see, this is the Philco Majest Touch 10 keyless, which I'm playing with, and you can see the difference. It's actually a very, very, very big keyboard. Even the function keys here are above the limit of my keyboard, so that's a very large one. So, what can you tell us about this keyboard? First of all, are you happy with this with this keyboard that you have now?
Yeah, actually, I'm very happy since I changed from a usual
membrane.
To this keyboard, and I actually bought it from a single-nail website on Le Bon Coin. I don't know if you heard it, but it was a part of a whole.
IBM stopped the production, I think.
In 1991.
Okay, so now there is a brand which is called Unicomp, which makes pretty much the same keyboard, but some say it doesn't sound the same.
The same system, but not the exact same models.
Okay.
There are actually a lot of different models.
This is the genuine one, right?
One of the genuine. You can see in this one of these numbers, actually this one, the 1391 402, actually represent the type of the M model. You have like
that's very rare. It was manufactured in the United Kingdom, which is very rare. Now everything is done in China or Taiwan. Yeah.
And actually, this number represents the type of the M model. You have like 20 or 30 different types of M model. This one is one of the biggest, I think, and it weighs like.
And there is something absolutely amazing about that keyboard, even though it's a very, very old one. You can see that the cable is actually detachable. That's amazing.
Yeah.
That's a new feature on new keyboards, but that one is how much? 20 years old?
And the first keyboard, it was always detachable.
Okay. Whoa, amazing.
Because you can see the length of the cable is quite huge.
That's about, what, 2 meters?
Even more.
Yeah, because this is a fucking elastic cable, man.
Yeah, it's fucking huge. It's like 2.5 or 3 meters, I think.
Yeah, that's what I was saying. Okay. Let's be serious a bit more. That's a gaming keyboard actually, because you can see that there are no Windows keys here.
Actually, the operating system Windows was not available at this time, so there was no Windows key because Windows didn't even exist. Yeah.
Oh my God.
The first Windows was
Bill Gates wasn't born.
Yeah. He was born. He actually developed Windows a few years ago, but not very spread around the world, let's say. So no Windows key, so it's actually perfect.
Don't you find it boring that the function keys are so far from the shift or the control key?
I don't use it. So
yeah, that's a LOL player, League of Legends.
Yeah, MOBA player don't use the function.
Don't use the keyboard. Yeah. Fucking retarded. Okay, sorry. What can we say? Maybe we can take off one key so that you just show us the technology. I'll let you speak about that.
Yeah.
That's a Philco keycap puller.
Yep. You can just.
Which obviously you don't know how to use.
Yeah. You just can pull it.
Okay,
like
so
this.
Very interesting. Up. You take. And take the keycap out, and you can see that inside the keycap.
Every keycap is actually in two parts. You have the. First part, the hat, I'd say, that is with the name of the key, and in under the keycap you have the actual system.
Yeah.
With the little.
with the little metal piece here, which we don't know the word for.
Yes, I don't remember it. Under this, anyway, this little part, you have a little plastic part about the size. About this size, like
that's why the keyboard is so heavy, actually, because beneath every single keycap, you have a single. You have another one.
Yeah.
Just like that, with no printing on it. Obviously.
And it's actually heavier than the first one.
So that's called the buckling spring technology.
Yeah.
And could you do some typing for us, just so that we can hear the amazing noise of that keyboard? And actually, it's amazing because it pretty much feels like the Cherry MX Blue switches, yeah, which have a click. So that's a tactile mechanical keyboard.
Yes.
You can pretty just shut your mouse for a second. We will hear that. But it's not a click like on a Cherry MX Blue. It's much more metallic. You really hear the noise of that. Metal beneath the keys. Yeah, we don't know the word for that fucking piece of shit. What can we say more? Do you find it nice to type? Do you find it precise or?
Yeah, actually very precise. I don't make a lot of mistakes during typing, but I'd say it's not for typing work. It's quite heavy and you can't.
You get tired very fast, maybe.
Yeah. Okay. A lot more than a classic mechanical keyboard like MX Blue or other switches, because it's quite heavy to
press it down. Yeah. Okay, so that's very nice to type on it, but not for too long, otherwise, you get very much tired. We will just reverse it once more. Could you tell us what this is here? It looks like, I don't know, what the fuck is this?
Actually, I don't fucking know. And I think it's absolutely useless.
All right.
I think it's part of this huge compartment that is empty, actually.
Seriously?
Yeah.
So why the fuck is there?
It's for the weight. It's for the weight of the keyboard. It's, you actually see it's in two parts.
Yeah.
You have the central part with all the keycap and the external parts.
Which is just
for show and actually for the weight. It's weight about 2.5 kilos, so it's fucking heavy.
So just to compare with a Philco, sorry about that. It's it's much heavier actually. It's even heavier than a Philco, which is already very, very.
I think. Because of the external compartment.
It's amazing, it's almost 20 years old, even more.
It's
25 years old and it's solid like a rock, nothing moves. The key, you don't have any problem with the keys?
No. Actually, when I first received it, I unmounted the whole keyboard.
Yeah.
Cleaned up all the keycaps, all the key, all the system.
Yeah.
The
whole thing.
Yeah, the whole thing, and remounted it, and it works perfectly.
Okay, right. Could you tell us a bit more about what there is beneath the keyboard itself? Is it a plate of metal? Is it
No, it's four different type of
plates of.
Of shit.
There is shit inside, don't fucking bite.
You have, you take the size of the
sheet
keyboard,
of paper.
And you have a weird sheet of, I don't know.
Dude, could you tell us what is a weird sheet?
I think it's in a tissue or whatever, it's to
sorry.
It's to absorb the shock of the typing, actually.
Oh, could you imagine the engineers back 25 years ago? What are we gonna use? Well, man, I'm just back from the toilets and I have an idea.
can use my huge shit I just dropped.
What the fuck, man? I said in the announcement about that preview that about that review that it was gonna be a serious and professional one. That's a total fail. So just let's be serious once again. And at least try it. You can see that he's very bad. He's very bad at drawing useless things. Squawk, what the fuck? Plop. Anyway, so just please note that the little parts here, which are here to prevent the keyboard from gliding, are quite short. So actually, even though it's a very, very heavy keyboard, you might have some troubles because it moves a bit, maybe a bit more than a Philco or a new mechanical keyboard. But it's so heavy actually that you would have a hard time trying to move it anyway.
You have to fucking press like a decat.
Alright. Here you can see that there is no part such as this one.
Yeah, it's pretty raw actually. So,
So even
it can damage everything if you push the keyboard on. So
okay.
Be careful. I actually
a mouse mat. Yes. You destroy your mouse mat with that.
No. But I have actually a huge mouse mat.
So, yeah, from Razer.
Yeah, from the like 1 meter large.
Yeah, sure.
So I put my keyboard on it and. Don't have any problem even from sliding or
for okay so it doesn't glide even though it's you have very small parts or none
on a house mat it doesn't glide at all.
Alright, I think we covered the whole thing. Do you have one last thing to say maybe? Just okay, so that's the light for the number padlock.
On a tankless
for the
you have it here. Okay.
Yeah. So that's the scroll lock, that's the how do you call that? Key lock, and that's the number padlock. Okay, all right. No Windows key once again. Important
no
to know.
No index key as well.
And actually, the keys themselves are quite heavy, but they are not very deep. You can't press them very deep.
No.
You smash the sheet of plastic very quickly.
Yes.
and so it makes it very, very nice to type on because you really can, you have a nice heavy feeling of each key with that particular tactile feeling, but it's quite short. The distance of typing is quite short.
Compared to the
this one
right here, much longer actually.
Yeah, already. So this was the IBM Model M review. I hope you enjoyed it. If you could like or subscribe to my channel, I really like it. Thanks a lot, man, for this very serious review.
Very serious.
We were very professional indeed.
Yes.
Thanks for watching. See you soon.